first came here, there was no one. All the others, they were lighter. First they would come to me, they would touch my skin, asking, feel my hair.
Something up. So, when I was 12, took childish, naive people. In fact, my head, I knew that we were gone to Ireland. So I left without saying goodbye to any of my family or friends. When we arrived to Ireland, I left Donegal, left back to Donegal, and finally Dublin. And ever since I was 12, I've been living here ever since.
Me.
I've been moving ever since. When I was 2, I've been moving. I remember when I was 5, I moved from Moscow to Copenhagen, then London, then Dublin. My granddad, who was a wise man, once said to me, I'll regret moving. Not in a bad way, though, because we had a great bond. And I've had that memory in my head ever since. And ever since, I've been moving.
My mom came to Ireland in 2006, and I didn't see her again until 2011. When I saw my mom again, the first thing I noticed was I was taller than her, because the last time I saw her, I was much smaller. I was so happy to see her again, and it was very emotional. So, when my uncle was 18, he moved to America. He didn't come back for 27 years. But we found out in May he was coming, so we're all excited. Tried to keep it a secret, but my dad went to the airport anyway. When I saw my uncle, I noticed he was really tall. My dad's tall, he was taller than my dad. He was wearing a Nirvana t-shirt, which is one of my favorite bands, so we clicked. We just spent the whole week together, and then on Wednesday, we went to my nan's and said goodbye. It was very sad, but we're hoping to see him again soon.
I moved to Ireland from Iran in 2012. It was really difficult to say goodbye to all my friends and all my family. It was most difficult to say goodbye to my brother. He was older than me when we were close. When we left the airport, we knew we'd be leaving him behind. I was crying. He was trying to be strong. Coming to Ireland was extremely difficult. At first, I didn't speak the language. I had no friends. And there was very little to do. for walks in the park with my friends. Going to the gym. 2 years in, my brother moved from Iran to Ireland. He called us when he got to the airport. I remember feeling so excited, but also very afraid. I hadn't seen him before. My mother and I took the bus to Tallaght. And then we took the news to the hostel where he was staying. I remember checking the time almost every 5 minutes. When we got to the hostel, I ran to my room. And I gave him a huge hug. That was my favorite hug.
When I was 4, my mother came to Ireland. After 2 years, she came back. And she told us that we were going for holidays. We got to the airplane, and we realized that we are actually not going for holidays, we're going to stay. So I didn't really get a chance to say goodbye to my family. When we got on the airplane, we met a guy who called Eddie. We got really connected. He was a stranger, but we bonded so quick. So the person that was really hard to say goodbye was actually Eddie. He helped us to get a taxi from the airport. We said goodbye and we came home. I was going to see my sister after 2 years. She was 10 by that time. We were in the living room and she was hugging and kissing all my brothers and my mother. When she arrived to me, she didn't recognize me. That I was actually her mother. And then I went to hug her, she smacked my head on the That was my fond look.
Whenever I go to Poland for my summer holidays, the airport is crazy. There's loads of people everywhere. And we're looking for either my auntie, my uncle, or my granddad to pick us up. When they pick us up, we go back to one of their houses and push them to eat. Whenever we go to my grandma's house, she makes gorgeous food. And she loves to make a Polish dish called gołąbki when we go there. So when I was younger and I used to visit Scotland, we would take the train and me and my dad would make fun of the next stop announcements because of their really funny accent. And then we realised that our uncle could just really easily pick us up. So that's what he did. We went back to our grandparents' house. And I would always expect a bowl of mac and cheese ready for me because that's what I love that she makes. Time flies really fast when we're in Poland. And sooner or later we have to go home. Before we do though, we visit all of my family because they all want to see us. So it's not a very relaxing holiday, but I enjoy it anyway. When we do leave, my granddad gets really upset and he cries, and then we cry. And then my uncle, my auntie, or my granddad drops us at the airport. When we get back to Ireland, it's really weird. It's a completely different world. So when we get back, I always remember the bubble on the glass door and the metal handle. And then our uncle would pick us up back to the airport. And it would smell like a beach because when we were younger, he used to take us to the beach with my family, and then I would probably be covered with sand. And then it would get all over the car. But he was not really bothered to clean it up after. So it smells like beach. And then when we got back to Ireland, it's just so quiet and so simple.
For me, I do not have a first hello or arrival. I have first goodbye. When I was leaving Philippines, I could see my grandma, who I had a really, really great relationship with, crying. And she would just come and hug me. And I didn't know what to do. I could not cry back because back in my head, I keep on saying that there's a whole world around me. And leaving my friends, my granny, behind, that's my first goodbye.
I moved to Ireland in 2007 from Ghana, and straight away I was put into school. But at first it was extremely hard because there was only four black people and all the other kids were being extremely racist. They were calling me names like monkeys. But it all changed when I joined the football team. I was really good at it, and the teachers liked me, and that led to all the other students liking me, and that gave me this huge confidence boost, which led me to saying hello to this one girl in my class. And I could just remember her saying, "Hello, Kelvin," and it gave me this exhilarating feeling. And throughout the day, I would play that back over and over again in my head. When I was walking home, I would imitate what she said because I was so excited and just extremely happy, and that was my favorite hello.
When I went into fifth year last year, I didn't know anyone because I skipped the year before that. So I still remember the first day when I went to the cafeteria, I didn't know anyone. I didn't know where to sit. When I saw these two girls sitting up by themselves, looking just like me, so I went over and sat beside them. And it turns out, those two girls were from an exchange project, and they were both from different countries. Yuki was from Japan, and Nut was from Taiwan. And that's how it started. It's amazing to me that in the space of 2 weeks, I went from knowing nothing about them to being like sisters, spending every waking moment with them. And that's the way it was the whole year. And it was great. But with college and school, time caught up with us. And the moment where they had to leave just caught up with us, and I did not see it coming. I still remember being in the airport. It felt so normal. We just got our bags sorted, and we went to Macdonald's because Nut had a favorite drink, and we would always go to Macdonald's to get our favorite drink. And it was just so ordinary. We stopped the last of our drinks, just as the flight got called out, and they left. And it just did not dawn on me for a long time. I still wanted to call them. I still wanted to call Yuki and just ask her to hang out. Only 3 days after, when I was wrapped, looking through my bag, I still remember finding this letter that Yuki stashed away. She said, "Thank you for being such a good friend from last year," and I had this little photo of us hugging, which I keep in my wallet everywhere. And I still remember reading this letter and just bawling my eyes out.
So last summer, my sister decided to move to Australia with her boyfriend. She had gotten good grades in college, but there wasn't that much great job opportunities here in Ireland. At the time, I was quite happy about this. Me and my sister, we didn't really have the best relationship. And I thought putting some distance between us would do us some good. But it wasn't until that day at the airport where we were seeing her off that I just kind of stopped and like tank for a minute. And it wasn't until I saw her go through the departure gates and turned around to give her final wave goodbye to us. And to have that physical barrier between us that I just realized I didn't hate my sister as much as I thought I did.
really valuable pictures of me, my friends, and my family. And whenever I'm sad, I like to look back at them and just smile about the memories we've made.
Thank you.
Sunday, me and my mom went down to my nanny's. She lives down in Wicklow, and there's this gorgeous forest just down the road. So me, my mom, and my uncle decided to go down and have a walk. So we stopped in the shop, got a few things for a picnic, and I got a few drawing pencils. So we go down to the forest, and we're sitting down, talking and eating, and I begin to draw a picture of us and the forest. It wasn't until years later that I realized I drew the cover of my favorite book that my mom used to read to me, and the figures were me, my mom, and my uncle.
Whenever my mom and dad fight, the house is excruciatingly loud, and my brother and sister are either screaming or crying, running around the house. And I need a place or something to get away from all that. I have my phone, which has all my music. So I go to my room, listen to the music, and it seemed as if everything would just stop.
Thank you.
TV. And the main character she was looking at was close enough to our age. And had the exact same problems as her. Had ups and downs. But what one thing that shocked the most to her was that she wrote out all her emotions and feelings onto a piece of paper. And then scrunched it all up and threw it away. So that kind of showed that she had no one to talk to and no one to understand her, thought she was a freak. She just get it all out, nobody could see it, and be gone. And she felt better and stronger about herself. That way, she found a new talent for herself in writing.
So, over time, Anna learned that she could write more than just her emotions down. She started writing down her ideas and daydreams, and over time they turned into stories and characters that she saw some of herself in, or the parts that she thought she couldn't be. And over time of reading these stories and writing them, she realized that just like the characters in her book who she had control over, she controlled over her own life as well.
See, Anna did not only write stories on this paper and just throw it away. She also loved to paint and draw and whatever. It just relaxed her a lot. She didn't know how to express her feelings, so that way she just started painting. And she wasn't that good at first, but I guess practice makes perfect. She was writing all the diaries and memoirs on the paper. She was reading them every night. She learned from her experiences and she became stronger and stronger every day.
I lost its connection to a culture. But at the same time, I found freedom.
The thing I lost is my grandmother, which wasn't a nice experience at all. And what I gained is a new language skill point. The one thing I found is confidence, and the one thing I lost is my best friend from Sanchez.
The thing I lost was family members and friends. The one thing I found, new friends I consider family.
The thing I lost is a distinct nationality. I've never known whether to call myself Irish or Scottish. And the thing I found is two cultures and two homes.
I lost one possible kinship,
helped me to write my first radio rap. And the one thing I found was confidence, courage, and determination. I feel like I can do anything.
As well as saying goodbye to my family and friends, I felt like